I live in a house now, good. Dave. Yes. But it's two apartments.
In a van down by the river.
Dave and I have an upstairs neighbor, and we live downstairs, but we share the same internet.
Okay.
Now, we do without any problems, usually.
Yeah.
Except that I have Google Home, and she has Google Home, and I have Spotify Premium, which
and she does by default if she's sharing your IP address.
Right, because you change your password, it doesn't matter. It's like on the same, it's on the Wi-Fi,
yeah.
Right? So everything changes. So the reason why I was alerted to this, I didn't even know it was a problem. Dave listens to Spotify far more than I do. But
this is Sasha's husband.
Yes, mm-hmm. But I, when I was driving home the other day, got an alert in my car saying that Spotify was playing Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And I thought, well, that's not Dave.
What do you? Yeah. Does it not link up to your phone or your device? Like, because I know we have
a lot of stuff is IP based, my friend.
Yeah,
and a lot of tracking is IP based, so you're going to start seeing advertising that belongs to the neighbor upstairs, or you're going to see like things that are related to their shopping habits over the holidays.
So what I need is a solution. It's not that I'm unhappy sharing these sorts of things,
sure.
But I would like my stuff to be mine. Like,
yeah.
I can broadcast. Actually, after we realized the trouble of it, I was broadcasting to her daughter back and forth.
You
right?
can chat using your Google Cast devices.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know what really scares me about the scenario? And let's share, right? You got more than enough bandwidth. Sure. Okay. So in a rental unit like that, sometimes we share our internet connectivity. But what is scary about this, Sasha, is you've got computers, right?
Yes.
Your neighbor, obviously, also has computers.
Yes.
What happens if they run a ransomware script on their computer? What if they open that ransomware email? You're connected to the same stinking network. You are on the same network, my friend.
This is exactly why I'm having this conversation right now, because until that point I didn't really think about it, and now I'm like, I need a thing. Like
Spotify is one thing, right? But also all your private files, they're on the same network.
Okay,
think about that for a second.
Okay, you not
I need a solution.
Buy another Wi-Fi
another Wi-Fi.
Like, you guys are sharing the internet, so you're saving money.
Yes.
So why not buy another Wi-Fi enabled router, then pick up like a $15 switch, and then run your feed from your actual modem into the switch, split off to the two routers, that way you both have your individual home networks.
Nope.
Why wouldn't that work?
Because what you're doing is you're creating two SSIDs. You're creating two WLANs, wireless LANs, okay? But those WLANs are both connecting to the same local area network, the same LAN. So the connectivity, it's like in an office building where you've got a warehouse in the back and the Wi-Fi doesn't quite reach there, you run a cable and you plug in another access point.
Right.
And it gives you access to what? The same network, right? So in this case, what the correct course of action I think Sasha would be, and you're almost there, Jeff. It's not a WLAN that you need, it's a VLAN that you need.
Okay.
So wireless LAN, that's one thing. But a VLAN is a virtual local area network. It allows you to create a virtual LAN within the current network, or essentially separate from it. So without the authentication to access that VLAN, the neighbor would not be able to access any devices that are connected to your VLAN. Those could be hardwired, those could be wireless, it could be whatever. Now, it is, Sasha, it's going to require a device.
Right.
I would probably look at, you can start with like a $50 MikroTik router in a small, you've got a small apartment, so that probably would work just fine. You can get a really decent MikroTik for about $150, and then that will give you like the really strong Wi-Fi signal. But I think you can get away with just like a cheap MikroTik and set up a VLAN. It's a little bit complex to set up, but a VLAN will be a separate network from the existing one, but sharing the internet connection.
That's exactly what I want, right?
Will the VLAN stop the ability of, you know, network attacks, you know, from ransomware and stuff like that?
From From their LAN to the VLAN, yes. Because there's no crosstalking between them other than the internet. Right. So if the neighbor was to open an email that had ransomware, right now, your scenario, Sasha, the scary thing is you have a Windows 10 machine.
I do.
It has Samba file sharing so that you can access your files from other devices. And so can your neighbor.
Yes.
They can also access your printer. They can also access your connected devices and everything else. If they click on a ransomware file, an executable, by accident, because it comes in looking like an invoice at Christmas time, or a shipment notification from UPS, and if they double-click on that and run it, it goes out on the network and finds all the devices that are susceptible, which means Samba on a Windows machine, for example, and destroys all the files. So that's your personal data. So, putting the VLAN separate from that will separate the two LANs.
So a VLAN would be enough. What's a virtual private network? Could I do that too? Like, should I do that too?
That's a different thing.
Is that a VPN? Okay, just V.
The V throws you. The VPN, the virtual private network, is so that you can connect out to another network that can be used in like a business environment so that somebody can connect from home to their work in a secure method. Some people use that to be able to access other regions of the world. For example, Netflix Canada doesn't have certain shows that they want, so they connect to a VPN in America. So that they can use Netflix America.
Okay,
right?
So I need a VLAN.
You need a VLAN to separate your local area network into a virtual local area network so that it's separate and segregated from the actual physical local area network.
Thank you.
Yep.
All right.
Does that bring us to the end?
I think it does.
Does that answer your question? I hope so. MikroTik are fantastic because they make routers that are really, really affordable. And I say that like they are the price of a standard router, but the features of like the Cisco's, like you've got access to things like VLAN creation and advanced routing and things that you would normally pay thousands of dollars for. You've got in a $100 router. It's
excellent.
Unbelievable.
Can you find me one? Maybe put it up in the store or something?
Cat5.tv/MikroTik.
Exactly.
Now, I mean,
there are no C's.
If we have 30 seconds, there's one question in the newsroom similar related to this.
In the chat?
In the chat room. Yeah. Sorry, did I say the newsroom?
You said the newsroom, yeah.
Solbu is wondering, would like a guest net, having that separate guest net, would that be sufficient in this case?
A guest network is different.
It is different?
Yeah.
So that won't solve the issue?
No.
Okay.
No, because that really is really to... That would protect the neighbor, but not you.
Right.
Okay? Because a guest network access on your router is, just understand that what that's built for is so that if I have a friend over, they can still use my internet, but not access my files.
Right.
So remember, that keeps them from being able to damage my stuff, but they can get damaged. Okay?
Right.
So, yeah, it would protect the neighbor, but it wouldn't protect Sasha.
Right. Okay.
So that's the distinction between them. It's a little bit different than a VLAN.
Right.
So.
Okay.
I mean, I don't want her to think I'm rude or anything.
No.
I'm taking back my Spotify because I don't mind that she listens to it. It's the symptom of a bigger problem. Once that happened, I realized, whoa, now.
Yeah.
You've got some stuff going on.
Yeah, yeah. Yep. And you do have things like you can only have so many devices on your Netflix account. Well, if they're on the same IP address, I don't know. No,
yeah,
I guess that doesn't really count because they've got to authenticate as you. But there are different services that use your IP. And I think about advertising at this time of year, too. Like,
oh my goodness.
When my pastor was getting ads from the shared network upstairs for tattoos and stuff. And it's just like, it just wasn't quite what she was looking for.
Right.
But those are the ads that she was getting served. So.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.